Darius, who is from Norway and also another senior participant was Anna Wallin, I think, who was the previous supervisor of Elin. It's like the Scandinavian team mainly. Some a few postdocs that came from several other places. So it's also very international, although it's leaded by the Scandinavian team. And in fact, these are quite tough women. Because their main activity is to do cruise and to do field measurement at the most difficult place near in Antarctica. And so they were interested to see how it compared with to better understand their observations from this project. Okay. Ah, yes, I need. Sorry. So the aim is to understand basically why the ice cap of Antarctica is shredding, is diminishing in size, in thickness. Yes. So there's some observation from satellite that show that the global thickness of the ice cap is decreasing versus time, and it seems to be an accelerating process. Although it's not quite uniform, it depends on where you are in Antarctica, so it's not well understood. And we don't think that it's due to the warming atmosphere because it's still too cold, so there's no melting really in Antarctica. But the idea is that it melt under the sea, because the sea itself is warming, and it go under ice shelves, which are glacier tongue that advance in the sea, and the idea is that it melt from below. And then if the ice, okay, so this is a photo of an ice shelf. So it's a big plate of glacier ice that floats, advance on the sea. So that it's very thick, every kilometer thick. We see only here the upper part, which is maybe 100 meter barrier, like Ross barrier, or there are several barriers like that. But they go down, and the ocean is quite deep there. It's 1,000 meter deep. And there are several of these. And this is the Ross, and this is the place where they did the study, the Weddell Sea. Okay, the idea is it melts from below, and here the Weddell Sea is the place. Here is Elin, who is very pleased to be among penguins. So now more precisely, the idea is that there is some warm water, relatively warm, a few degrees beyond zero, but it's enough to bring some a very large heat flux that can melt the ice cap, which is So the idea is a kind of convective process, with warm water coming in, and fresh water from the melting of ice going upward. But in fact, this idea will be simple without Coriolis effect. And because of Coriolis effect, this motion is strongly prevented by constraint of Coriolis force. So this cannot be that simple, because Coriolis force prevents cross flow, the flow across the topography gradient, the thickness gradient. I will come to that next. And so this is a very well-known F of Taylor column. So I just remind that for people who are not familiar with that. So if you have a uniform density and a slow flow, so-called small Rossby number, the velocity is small compared to the typical velocity of the flow is small compared to the rotation rate. In that case, if you have a topography in the bottom, like here, the flow even above the topography is following the same streamlines. And there's a very famous experiment by Taylor. You see in rotating time, you see the dye, which is above the topography, that go around, like if the topography was a full column. And so it's quite generic. If you have the flow does not like to go across the gradient of thickness, the thickness needs to be along the iso thickness line. So in principle, if there is no density stratification, if the flow is slow enough, it could not cross below the ice shelf. But because of two effects, because below the ice shelf, you have the barrier, so the thickness is changing abruptly, so the flow could not come in. And there is another effect before going to the barrier, because there is some, if you look at the, this is Antarctica, the flow is coming like that, and there is there is a continental shelf, a change of topography. This is a slope here, the deep ocean. There is a shallow part here. Part of the flow goes here and is lost, can be lost for a melting effect. And deeper flow can go here and deeper part, and then it can go under the ice, as shown is here, and then you have fresh water coming out. So to go here, first we need to not to go here or not to go here. We need to cross the barrier in the right way, and then the second barrier due to the front of the ice shelf. And this is so this is why there are two parts in the study, in fact. One is to understand how the flow comes to the trough. This is a trough, which is sketched here. This is a laboratory equivalent. So you have land, you have a flat part which represents the continental shelf, and a deeper part here, the trough. The question is whether if you have some flow, we inject the flow here, whether it goes here, whether it goes here, here, and what part going to the different places. It's depending on the condition of stratification and the flow rate. So the experiment is shown here with the laser illumination. The dye is represented by a laser fluorescent dye, which is illuminated by a laser, so you see fluorescent. So we see a cut of the current here, which is coming from here, and you see here, at this condition, very little is going here, but most of it goes south. It would go to the under the ice cap. But of course, this depends on the condition. But you see that everything is very turbulent, which makes things complicated, and it makes the experiment interesting, because you see, even the best numerical simulations are not able to describe all this turbulence. Okay, so this is a result from particle imaging velocimetry. So instead of dye, we put in that case small particles and some velocity field. And we see this is a barotropic case, so we have a uniform density current here. And we see that thanks to the Taylor Proven theorem, indeed the flow does not go here and it tends to stay here and not in the trough. Well, it is a barotropic current of light water. The light water tends to stay in the surface. In that case, it can go in, penetrate in the shallower place here, because it's kind of the effect is blocked by stratification. So you have a competition between stratification and rotation. Rotation tends to produce a vertical column, while stratification tends to cut the current. Okay, and these are particle tracking from the PIV, so it's a numerical kind of fake tracking of particles that are obtained from the succession of heuristic fields. So we see, basically, I prefer to analyze in terms of particle trajectory than system heuristic fields. So we see the same thing here, particles go away, and here, particles stay. And from that, they can do some statistics. So they define three regions. Particles that go here, the continental shelf, particles go to the trough, and particles that go straight here. They're interested in the proportion of V to others. And they find that this proportion depends. This is for a uniform stratification. In that case, it depends on the flow rate here. The flow rate is here. It depends on some non-dimensional parameter. The inverse of the Rossby number, so they are able to characterize how the part of the flow that goes to the trough depends on the flow rate. And also they compare, there's another trick, is the corner here, but here it's a round corner, but they did also experiment with a straight angular corner. In that case, you get the black dots, and in that case it's less regular. And you can see that here. Here it's an instant view. You see that in a flat, here smooth corner it goes like that. And if you have a square corner, there is a detachment. It's much more unstable with the edit. And so it changes, of course, the flow rate that can go through. Okay. And, okay, now the second problem is the, as I said, once you arrive in the trough, what happens when you hit the ice shelf itself? So there is a second set of experiments with a kind of canyon like that, long canyon, which is with ice shelf. It was not with ice, it was just plastic. but it's just a mechanical effect that we are interested in. And also they could change the density of the current. Yes. And the question again is whether it will go through the ice shelf or if it just go around and not penetrate. And again, it will depend on stratification and flow rate. So here is an image of the experiment. So we have 5 meters long here. And we have the source of the current. And because of Coriolis force, it's pushed to the side. And then depending on the... If you have no stratification, you have a vertical boundary of the current. Because of the, again, because of Taylor-Pugnan theorem, the thing is aligned in the vertical. But if it's stratified, there's a competition between the density effect and which sets the angle of the interface. And we have the ice shelf here, and different configurations of the ice shelf as were used. Like that, there's like no ice shelf in practice. Title roof or vertical front. So, because it's kind of schematic representation of different kinds of ice shelf shape. Basically, the actual expression is between this and this. It's a good schematic way to understand the two effects. Okay, so this is the. So here it's a cut, transverse cut in that case. You see that in the, for the barotropic case, it's no stratification. You have indeed, as I said, the interface is vertical, aligned with rotation. And flow is pushed by the Coriolis force, but it's kind of stopped by a pressure effect. And when you have a density effect, as I said, we have a stilted interface, which depends on the competition between density effect and Coriolis force. Well, just as a remark, a technical remark, here we use particles, and here we use dye. We try to avoid using dye because the problem is to, with this big facility, is to remove that. So after that, it becomes contaminated. So it's particle, the advantage can be removed. So we try to avoid putting too much dye. Okay, so this is from PIV. So you see indeed that in the uniform density case, barotropic, the flow is indeed blocked. In the shelf is here, you see, it goes here, it's blocked, it goes back. And there is very little flow inside. When it is stratified, it goes through here, as expected. But then, of course, we can, there are intermediate cases. There are different experiments with different configurations, as I said. You have intermediate cases as well. But these are the two extreme possibilities. Okay, and this is quite interesting to interpret field data. Well, this is the Antarctic ice shelf in which they are interested. And there are some mooring here. They measure velocity at different places, and it's more convenient to be a little away from the ice shelf. It's quite difficult to do measurement quite on the edge of the ice shelf. So there are very few measurements, only one place here. And you see there's a big difference in velocity away from the ice shelf and very close to the ice shelf. And the difference depends on the density stratification. The yellow arrows correspond to the warm. Yes, cold. This is what you suppose. When it is Bouquets on the right. Yes, the yellow are warm. No, yes, it's okay. When it is warm, it means that basically there's no stratification. And when there is no stratification, you see the current is very large here, but then it's very small here. So it's very blocked when you reach the barrier. When we have stratification, but from to white, there's not much difference. And so and people previously used this data to estimate the flow rate through the ICF. So the conclusion is that there's not basically as much flow rate under the ICF that was expected from previous measurement. So using this experiment, they were able to understand that it's important to do measurement very close to the ICF and to take into account the stratification to use the data away from the ICF. So it helps to design new experiment as well. And but as I understood, the situation may be different in other for other ICF. Apparently, there are different behavior on the both side, and it seems that indeed the observation seems to indicate that the two ICF behave in a different way. One is melting very fast, and this one may not melt so fast. So it's not so okay. This is what I said. I stress smaller than previously thought, but closer to myself. Okay, there's also some discussion about the need to have enough resolution to be able to capture the barking flow. Okay, thank you for your
Thank you.
attention. The follow-up is first to publish everything. It's already a big job because there are two configurations, there are many data, and so this is the first priority. But it's clear that they okay after that. So far we priority is to understand everything first to publish thing. To after that maybe we. Sure, all these mechanisms are fairly generic, and so they are. What I think is we also need to make closer link with numerical simulations because these people are really doing field measurements, but there are all the people who do numerical simulation and which apparently are not so satisfactory, as I understood from the papers. So I think this would be the good thing to do. Not so much doing new experiments again, but doing more analysis and better understanding all the results that we have. Because we have terabytes of data, and so it's always a problem with this experiment for this platform. It takes a very long time to really fully exploit what we have. Okay. Yes.
So you mentioned numerical simulations there. Have there been any numerical modeling of this simple laboratory case?
No, this we don't. No, this is something we want to do more. Yes, it's always yes. We did numerical distribution, but in more simple cases. Okay, this case is quite complex. We see something between the really academic problem and real situation. So you see, they have several levels, things that are. So generally, in a purely fundamental study, we are interested in more simple configuration, and some other people are really interested in the actual geography. So this is something in between, which was not really no, was not studied. Yes, but there is a need, I think, to go from simple academic situation to more complex. Yes, because I know that you work often on the simple the problem of exchange flow in the canyon, but you didn't put ice shelf probably. You see, there are some things that are not in.